talking to Cole Pacunas with the North Museum in Lancaster about this lunar eclipse for tomorrow.
It's special. It hasn't happened for 3 years now, and hopefully we will all be able to get a good glimpse of this, Cole. So when we do look up into the sky at the moon, what do you think that we'll see?
Yeah, so assuming that there's not too much cloud cover, right around 2:30, like you said, it's going to be full blood red, get that crimson hue that gives it its name, and it'll be full bright and red in the evening, or in the early morning, sorry.
And we're seeing some video here that looked pretty neat, kind of what we can expect to see. And I know you actually do some educational programs for people to learn more about this.
So we have astronomy shows on the weekend here, and then every month we have a night sky tour, which covers the night sky you can see every on the nights in Lancaster, PA. So that's a local thing. It's actually happening this Saturday at the North Museum. So I'm going to talk a bit about the lunar eclipse in case people didn't get to see it in person, and other things you can see in case you did miss it.
And Cole, for the solar eclipse, there was only that strip of the country that really got to see the totality. Is that the same thing for the lunar eclipse? Are we in that path, or is it more broad that more people can experience this?
Nope, it is much, much broader than the path of totality for the solar eclipse. Basically, as long as you can actually see the moon between those hours of 2:30 and 3:30 a.m. tomorrow morning, you will be able to see the full lunar eclipse. So anywhere in North America should be able to see it, weather permitting.
And Cole, unlike the solar eclipse, no special glasses needed this time around, right?
Best observed with the naked eye, or if you have some binoculars, that could provide an even better view, but you should feel free to look with just the naked eye. It's totally safe, and anyone can look up and see it.
Very cool. Get the kids up, have them go outside, check it out, then go back to bed, you know, for a little bit.
Yeah, maybe they have off for St. Patrick's Day for the holiday weekend or something, that they won't have to get up too early for school, and they can get up even earlier. 2:26, that's the timing. You see it on their screen there, until 3:31.
Hey, Cole, thanks for joining us this morning and letting us know about this little bit of celestial history that we'll see, hopefully, tomorrow in the skies. Thanks for that.